protest, you're in fear of being killed. There is kids being killed, women, men getting beaten, killed just for protesting to have a free society like how we have here. Yeah, it's right where you have the right to protest and change the government if you want to, but over there, the current regime, Rashad, and everything, there are people getting killed for just going out and protesting. Ryan's.
It's like America. We have all completely evolved. You talk to a 10-year-old now and he knows about politics. They're paying dearly for it. It's such an amazing, for me, romantic story. I've never seen such people so much in love with freedom. And they're paying for it every day. Every day they're losing. Literally, this is honest to God's story. They're losing about 100 people a day. And Syria is Dallas. It's not that big. You can't even go like Dallas and Austin. It's not that big. It's right on the Mediterranean Sea, south of Turkey, north of Israel.
Watched the news a little while back, about in January or February,
yeah.
And everything they had on the news about one of the places that the Republicans, these guys were. Their troops kept coming in, bombing. It was all over CNN about that place getting bombed constantly until his regime could actually go in there and take over that town and push them out. He is pushing them out of every place, killing anybody in sight. He's got people that, like how you see our police, he's got other people that look like police, but are not, that would actually take you, beat you down because you're protesting.
Just because you're protesting like this, just because if you're just going out to the street for more than 15 minutes, you are honest to God killed. They shoot them by snipers. They've got snipers on rooftops. And it's Damascus. imagine this right now. It looks very similar to this downtown Damascus. Oh, only a lot of people. And they've got snipers right here, snipers right there, snipers right there. And
all the way around you.
We're standing here.
Troy, were you walking down this street, coming up this way? You got snipers on these buildings taking out people.
You're dead.
How would you feel if instead of a car, you would see a tank rolling this way, just shelling a building that's full of people? Just people like you and your cousins and your parents. That's what they're living right now. If you go to YouTube and type Syria, look at the things that they're doing to the people. Seriously, just a tank coming. And this is a new tank. I mean, I don't know, but you know, I'm not an army guy, but the weapons that these tanks have, you know, like you have a picture of a tank and you know it moves really slow, right? And then it ends. No, this is going, you just like
that right there.
It's the freakiest thing you will see.
You can't even aim it right. When you want to fire from it, you can't really aim it by more than 10 meters. So when it's gonna hit, it's gonna hit, and it hits on civilian buildings. Where people are living.
Have you guys seen the M1A1A Abrams tank of the military? There's one thing, when you go home tonight, go on the internet, go on Google, type in M1A1 Abrams tank. Okay? Watch its firepower. Watch what it does to a building, to anything that they've actually put in its way. It will roll over. It will take out. Put it this way. This church right here, what used to be a church, this little red building right here, it would take out that building within about 4 shots. And the M1 Abrams tank, our tank, could take out that building in 4 shots. And that's sitting a distance away. Imagine what that shell does to people. Right, when they are shelling buildings with you in it, your mom, or you guys go out. Like how you and your parents go out, right? Walk outside your house. Could you imagine standing there and watching your mom and dad get beat? Because you guys just stepped out of your house because you guys were going to go somewhere. They figured you guys were protesting. So your parents just got beat. Now they're going
to
come after you.
They did that to a singer that is actually here in this country. His name is Malik Jindali. He lives in Washington, D.C. and he's a very, very famous pianist. His parents are still living in Syria. When he started protesting here in the United States, not in Syria, here in the United States, in July of 2011, they went into his parents' house and they beat the crap out of them. We have pictures of his parents' faces. Scary. One is, the dad is like 70 and the mom is 65.
He doesn't care. There's one thing, you protest against him, it's just like, have you guys read the Bible? You remember what they say in the Bible about the wages of sin is death? To him, that's what he's putting against protest. You know, he goes against what the Bible says. Do not harm your fellow person. Okay? But see, to him, you protest, that's death. He don't care.
And he's not bad looking. He doesn't look like a murderer. The man is a physician. He's an optometrist.
He was actually educated here, right?
No, he was educated in England. Hold on, one second, please.